Layout is part of SketchUp Pro. It's designed to document and present your SketchUp models. To follow along with this tutorial, you'll need a SketchUp model. Use a model you've created or find one from the 3D warehouse. To begin, save your model and send it to Layout through the File menu. Layout will ask for a template to start with. There are default templates corresponding to standard paper sizes or title blocks. For our example, let's use a plain paper template. A window into your SketchUp model is placed on the page. This window is easily manipulated with the Select tool, which is in fact a multi-tool. You can select the window, move it around on your page, drag on an edge or corner of the window to resize it, and even rotate this window with the Rotate gizmo. Many of the tools in Layout function similarly to their SketchUp counterparts, and this is true of the Select tool. You can click to select a single object, or drag a selection window. Remember, a selection window going right to left selects any objects crossed by the window, where a selection window going left to right will only select what is completely inside the window, just like SketchUp. Select and scale our window so it covers about half the page. As with the Move tool in SketchUp, you can create copies of objects by moving them and pressing and holding the Control key on a Windows machine or the Option key on a Mac. Begin moving our SketchUp window, press the Control or Option key, and create a copy of the model window. Scale this window and create a third copy above it. With these three windows of our SketchUp model, let's explore the real power of Layout. Use the Select tool and double-click on one of the windows to change the view of the SketchUp model itself. You can use the scroll wheel on your mouse, just as you would in SketchUp, roll the wheel over different parts of the model to zoom toward that area, press the wheel down to orbit, and press the wheel down in combination with the Shift key or the left mouse button to pan. Try this on all three windows. Create a unique view of your SketchUp model for each window. Now right or context click on one of the model views and choose Open with SketchUp. Back in SketchUp, make some changes to your model, to the geometry or materials, and save your work. Switch back to Layout, and those changes you make will be updated in all the model windows. If your model does not update automatically, right or context click on the windows and choose Update Model Reference. This is the power of Layout. It creates a direct link to your SketchUp model, giving you powerful printing, presentation, and documentation capabilities. With this introduction, let's look deeper into the Layout tools. Some are built to complement the connection with your SketchUp model, and some are built to make Layout a powerful tool on its own. Start by opening the SketchUp model dialog box from the window menu. One of the things you should notice is a number of settings are identical to options in SketchUp. Select one or more of our view windows and toggle the shadows or fog. You also have all the default styles available from SketchUp, or any unique style saved with your model. Try this. Make one of your windows larger so it overlaps other views. Make it the top image by right or context clicking, and from the submenu choose Arrange, Bring to Front. Now select all three windows and choose a basic style with a standard white background. Toggle the background off, and watch how your model geometry creates its own clipping mask, making for unique compositing options. Speaking of clipping masks, another way to create them is to draw one shape over another. Use the Circle tool and draw a circle to highlight part of the model. Now select both the circle and the SketchUp window, right or context click, and choose Create Clipping Mask. There are many drawing tools for creating unique shapes in Layout. Unlike SketchUp, overlapping or touching shapes do not automatically break. However, you can combine multiple shapes by using the split tool to break edges and the join tool to weld touching edges together. To control how these and other shapes look, open the Shape Style dialog box. Here you can change settings such as line weight and fill options. Play with these settings and note that you can select SketchUp windows as well. Also note, you can affect shapes you have already selected, or if nothing is selected, you can change the default settings for future shapes. Let's create a new page for our document by opening the Pages dialog box. You can create a new blank page or duplicate any selected page. We'll duplicate this page and change the SketchUp views. Delete one view and resize the others into a horizontal orientation. We'll make these into orthographic elevations. Select one view, and using the SketchUp dialog box, pick a standard view from the front or side. Now select a scale that fits well on our page. You will likely need to edit this view using pan to best position it. Repeat this process with our second view. Select it, choose an orthographic view, a scale, and position it on the page. Now use the annotation or dimension tools to document your model. The tools will snap to your actual model geometry. You can toggle this snapping on or off as needed. Context click in a blank area to toggle object or grid snapping on or off. One final note as you start using Layout. Under the File menu, choose Document Setup. There are several settings here that will be useful to you. We just saw the ability to toggle and snap to grids, and here's where you can customize that grid. You can also change the page size or default units. Under the Page tab is also the rendering resolution. This is important to keeping Layout running smoothly. Keep the edit quality setting at medium or low to maximize the speed of Layout while you are working. But when you are ready to export images or PDFs, your output quality can be set to medium or high for great results. There are many more features to Layout that will help you work quickly and change how you share your SketchUp models. So continue exploring or look into more of our learning materials.